Since the Cartesian coordinate system is probably relatively familiar to you, we will frame our initial discussion of vector algebra in this system. First, note that any vector in this system may be described as a scaled sum of the three unit vectors. In other words, a general vector A may be written as some scalar times the unit vector AX, plus some scalar times the unit vector AY, plus some scalar times the unit vector AZ, like this. In scalar algebra, there are four basic operations: add, subtract, multiply, and divide. In vector algebra, we have pretty exact corollaries for addition and subtraction, but we have two different ways to multiply, the dot product and the cross product, and there's no way to divide. If you are given two vectors A and B, defined in Cartesian space like this, the sum of those two vectors may be found by adding the coefficients of each unit vector, like this. The sum may also be found graphically. So in this case, you draw both vectors, one originating at the origin and the other originating at the tip of the first. The sum of the two vectors is the vector that points all the way from the origin to the tip of the second vector. The process for finding the difference of two vectors is very similar. It can be done numerically by taking the difference of the coefficients of each term, like this. Or it may be done graphically. So if you're subtracting b from a, you'll begin by flipping the direction of b to find negative b. Then you add a and negative b using the same tip-to-tail method as before. The difference of the two vectors is the vector pointing from the origin to the tip of the second vector. Two things are important to note about these vector sums and differences. The first is that the sum of two vectors is a vector, and so is the difference of two vectors. The other important note is that this process only works if the vectors are defined in Cartesian space. Please do not try to use these formulas with vectors in cylindrical or spherical coordinates. Whenever you need to add or subtract vectors, your first step should always be to convert them into Cartesian coordinates.